In this video, let's unbox the Nokia 6. Now, if you are interested in buying the device, link is there in the description box and it is priced at 15,000 rupees here in India, available exclusively on Amazon. So use my link, that will definitely help out the channel. And we will have a look at the specifications as usual later in this video. So opening up the box pack, let's see what do we get first. So on the top is the Nokia 6. And we will keep it aside for now because we will have a look at it later in this video and I will also give you my impressions on this device. Now, in terms of contents, let's see what do we get in the box. So inside the box pack, we get earphones, which are standard earphones, nothing special, old school Nokia earphones, not even in-ear style earphones. You get USB to micro USB cable for charging as well as data syncing, no USB Type-C. I just hope that Nokia will use USB Type-C next time. Anyways, you get a power adapter, which is not a fast charger actually, but it comes with 5 volt and 2 ampere rating, which is better compared to LG because they decided to give 1.2 amp charger in 2017. I don't know what's wrong, but yeah, it is still better compared to LG. Anyways, you get a pin to remove the SIM tray slot and some documentations. And by the way, if I said it wrong, it is 5 volt and 2 ampere power adapter. Anyways, let's move ahead and let's quickly take a physical overview of the Nokia 6. So on the front, we have a 5.5 inch full HD display with Corning Gorilla Glass protection on top. And at the bottom, we have two touch capacitive buttons, which is back and multitasking key. Both the buttons light up. In the center is the fingerprint sensor, which is not a physical button, but if you touch it, it will take you back to the home screen. Now on the top, we have a earpiece which also acts as a speaker, 8 megapixel front camera with 84 degree wide angle lens, and it is coming with f2.0 aperture and Nokia branding. At the rear side is the 16 megapixel camera with f2.0 aperture, only capable of shooting 1080p videos, LED flash, Nokia branding, and there is a 3000 mAh capacity battery which is sealed inside. At the bottom, we have a micro USB port, primary microphone and a speaker. And moving on to the right side of the device, we have a power button and the volume control key. Both the buttons are made out of metal and I will talk about it in a bit. On the top is the 3.5 mm headphone jack. So yes, headphone jack is still there on the Nokia devices. So guys, I've been using the Nokia 6 for about 24 hours, not exactly 24 hours, but for almost 20 plus hours I'm using this device. I fully charged it and then I started using this device. So I will show you the battery stats. And I will talk about the battery much more in my in-depth review, but this is just my initial impressions, so don't take it as a review. So let's start with the build quality of this device. It is excellent in my opinion. It feels as if I'm holding a metal slab, which is of very great quality. This device is extremely well built and I don't think there is any device even close to this device when it comes to build quality. You also get this chamfered edges, which looks really amazing. And on the front, if we talk about the design, you do get to see these big bars on the top and bottom, which is slightly too big, but yeah, that's fine. If you talk about the buttons, they are slightly flushed. They are not raised, but you might get used to it and the buttons are good. I don't really see any major complaints with it. Although I am disappointed with this camera bump, as when you keep it, it's slightly wobble, like you can see, and it might get scratched up if you don't use a case or something. So I'm worried about this thing. Now moving ahead, if we talk about the fingerprint sensor, it's not the fastest I would say, but if you like unlock it like this, it is fast. So in that way, like, it's not the fastest in my opinion. Now if we talk about the UI, it is very stock like UI. You don't really get any customization or anything on top of Android 7.1 Nougat on this device, which is good. And there were few applications pre-installed, most of them from Amazon. So anyways, you use Amazon applications, so it is completely fine in my opinion. There is no bloatware on this device. Now talking about the software, as I said earlier, it runs on Android 7.1.1 Nougat out of the box. But the security patch over here is of June, which I don't know why, but yeah, it is of June and I hope that they send out the August security patch soon, as soon as possible. Now talking about the storage, you get about 21 to 22 GB of storage free after the first boot and about 1 to 1.4 GB of RAM free after the first boot. Now the RAM that is available right now is about 899 MB because I'm using this device since last 24 hours. Now one more thing that I've noticed in my 24 hours of testing is that when you turn off the Dolby surround sound, the output gets a little louder. When you turn this on, the sound quality is good, but the output is a little low. And yeah, that's why I turned it off. And let me actually play a YouTube video so that you can judge how the sound quality is and how the display is on this device. So let me just quickly play a YouTube video for you guys.
How is the memory management on both the devices? Starting up with Chrome browser, let's open my website, which is babygarbhai.com, and let's see which device will open up first. And it is Redmi Note 4. But Nokia 6 is not far behind. It is catching up very fast. So there's not a huge difference.
So in my opinion, the sound output is good after you turn off Dolby Surround. But when you keep it on, the quality of the output is good if you keep it on. So it's a personal preference. I would prefer to keep it off. And viewing angles are good. I don't really see any issues with it. The output from the speaker over here is good. And just keep a note that, I mean, this is a good thing about the Nokia 6. You get this speaker as well as the output comes from this earpiece, so you get a really immersive experience when you watch some video. So that is really good about the Nokia 6. Now, I have also used the device for about 24 hours and I completely drained like almost 100%. So I did took the screenshot, and the screen on time that I'm getting over here is about 3.4 to 3.5 hours. So it's okay-ish, I would say. It's not the best battery life, but these are just my initial impressions, and I will come up with a dedicated review, so stay tuned for that. And you can see my 24 hours usage. So yeah, that's how the battery life is. I have clicked a lot of pictures over here, which I will show you in a bit. So guys, I'm recording this video with the Nokia 6 rear facing camera, and there is no 4K video recording on this camera. Let's see how the focusing is. There is face detection autofocus. And you can see that it focuses pretty quickly, so there is no issues over there. Let's try to focus on these flowers, and you can see that the focusing is quite good. There's no issues. This is how it looks like. So let me know how is the stabilization on this device, because I can't judge without seeing it on my computer. I'm doing this test to see the stabilization on the Nokia 6, and yeah, let's see how it is.
Now here is the focusing test, and as you can see, the focusing speed of the Nokia 6 is good and I don't see any complaints over here. Now when you click pictures in artificial lighting or low light situations, the pictures turn out to be average, I would say. They are not completely bad, but they are not that great also. So I don't really have any major complaints for now, but I will talk about all these stuff majorly in my full review, so stay tuned for that. And if we take pictures outdoors, you will see that the dynamic range is sort of average. And if you use HDR, definitely you will get better results. So I would recommend you to use HDR.